The mass airflow sensor, MAF sensor, or as it's also known, the air mass measurement sensor, sits here just after the airbox. If it's faulty, you can end up with a whole multitude of problems, rough running, very sluggish performance, as well as poor miles per gallon, so very poor fuel economy. The bonnet on my car needs replacement, so in order to replace it, first of all, you have to remove the plug. So if you pull on the tab towards the top of the plug, that will then come off. Hose to unclip, which literally just pulls off, and then we need some pliers to take the clip off here. So to remove the clip, I use mole grips, just hold on, and you can then move that to the side so that the tube comes out. I found the easiest way to get the sensor out, the MS sensor, is once you remove the clip at the back, is to actually remove the airbox. So there are about 8 Torx screws that need to be undone. That will then lift off and it will give you access to both of the Phillips screws. So just undoing the screws, done that one, working our way round. So once you've undone all the screws, it's just a case of lifting the airbox off, and you can now see the air mass meter, which is here, and the two screws, which are actually Torx screws as well, that need to be undone. The air mass meter may feel quite tight in here, and there's actually a rubber seal on the inside. Obviously you need it to be a completely airtight seal, so you just need to gradually pull the two apart and release the meter. Now it's removed, you can just see the rubber gasket seal that's sitting around the edge. Just need to put that back in place, and this is then the mass airflow meter, or air mass meter. What I've found is that the air mass meter is quite often an exchange unit, so we need to remove this to take it to the car parts shop to be able to swap for a new one. You can see the part number on the side here. So I've now got the replacement unit, which comes with plastic caps at either end to keep any dirt out before we fit it. You can see on the side of the sensor an arrow showing where the direction of airflow is. So the airbox connects on this end. So just tightening up the screws, which is then connecting the airbox and the sensor together. And then put the airbox back in place. Just need to tighten up the screws for that. And once the pipe's in place, release that, click the plug in place, put the tube back on, make sure it's clipped onto the side there so it's not loose. The final step is just to tighten up all the screws on the airbox, which should be T25s.